another one that we get to try ourselves. So let's check it out. Here we've got some great Color Garden pure natural food colors.
Oh, those will be nice for cookies or something.
Definitely. And it looks like we've got three boxes here, and they each have red, yellow, blue, and orange. So those will be awfully fun to try out. Might make some Betty Crocker Spritz cookies or something. Those are our favorite to use with food dye. And here we've got a little pamphlet with some stuff to remember. It says, all natural means always fresh. Use the entire packet for best results. Color Garden colors are liquid colors. And adding lemon juice or baking soda helps to activate proper color. So that'll be fun. We'll have to check those out. And here we've got a cute little sticker. That'll be great. So don't forget to like our video. We'll leave a link to the Moms Meet website in the description. See you later. Hello everyone. Making some cupcakes with my little ones so that we can frost them with some of the great food dyes that we got. So we'll be checking those out. Here are these great Color Garden pure natural food dyes. We're going to use these to frost some, or to color some frosting. That'll be fun. I got a couple different kinds of frosting. I got this Pillsbury white frosting, and we also got some whipped cream. So we'll check it out because we got some people in the family that like each kind. So we'll try this on both. We'll let you know what we think.
Where's my little thing of my little guy? Little penguin guy.
I don't know. We'll find it. But here we are. We're going to use some of our Color Garden food colors to color some. We're going to try it out with some Pillsbury white frosting and also some Cool Whip. Let's see what we like better. We tried them out with some cookie dough a couple weeks ago, and it actually kind of ruined our cookie dough. It turned it sort of into more of a bread dough than the cookie dough we're used to. So we read the instructions a little more carefully, and it says to use them really as to color some frosting. So that's what we're doing today. We made some fun cupcakes here, and we're going to color them up.
And
so let's get started, huh?
And we also made chocolate ones in there.
We did. They're not quite done yet. All right. What should we use with the frosting kind? Should we use yellow or red? Scoop some into our dish.
Yellow.
Okay.
I like the color yellow and red.
Squeeze it up. I'll kind of mix it up a bit.
Oh.
And let's open it.
Mustard
and lava, that's crazy.
Mustard and lava and bread.
Look at what a pretty yellow that is.
I know.
Let's maybe get a little more frosting.
Bloop.
Found in there.
Such a beautiful yellow, right?
Yeah. Mix up that white part.
Do you think we should show?
Look at what a pretty yellow that's turning. I like how vibrant these colors are.
Yeah. They're really nice.
Alright, should we put some on a couple cupcakes here?
Sure. Hope these taste delicious with this frosting.
Are you going to have the first bite?
Sure.
Alright, there's one of those.
Hope those ones taste really good. The ones that kind of look like birthday ones.
You can go ahead and have a bite whenever you are ready. Just do a couple now. this one to the side. We will work on our Cool Whip kind.
Can't even get it.
Grandma doesn't like real sweet frosting, so we like to make the Cool Whip frosting for Grandma, huh? That's nice. Alright, we're gonna
do. She's not here.
I know, but she'll be here soon. I'm sure she'll be here in time to enjoy some cupcakes. Let's pour this in. I think we're just gonna use half this time. We're not using that much whipped cream. See what half does for us, or about half anyway.
Oh, this is pretty good. You want the rest of it?
Smell this. It smells kind of like raspberry or something.
You want the rest of this stuff?
No, thank you. You go ahead and finish it off, or see how this mixes in.
Well, it already kind of filled me up. It filled me up.
Maybe we do need the whole pack. Kind of squeeze it in there. Kind of might need a lot if you were hoping for a lot of frosting. It seemed to definitely mix into the frosting better than it is the whipped cream, don't you think? It made a much nicer yellow in the frosting. Having a bit of trouble here mixing this up into the whipping cream.
Yeah.
Cool Whip.
Cool Whip.
Yeah, it definitely worked better with frosting. The color is certainly
pinkish.
Not as vibrant here in the Cool Whip, but
it was
still a nice kind of salmon color, I guess, instead of red, huh?
It's kind of a pinkish, reddish.
Should we frost a cupcake and taste it?
Sure. But that frosty, I'm not even gonna say it.
There you go, and I'll taste this one.
Good cupcakes.
And definitely,
can you get the wrapper off for me?
The flavoring definitely doesn't seem to have any, or I mean the coloring doesn't seem to have any flavor. So that's good. It's not affecting the taste of the cake itself.
Oh, it does.
This has been a blast, huh? These are tasty, so I guess we'll know for the future, too. It's usually best to, I guess, just color some regular frosting with these. We'll avoid kind of using the whipped cream, and we'll definitely avoid using it for our cookie dough again, but frosting coloring seemed to work great. Very vibrant, and we're definitely liking it.